Hi everyone, today we're gonna make these strawberry shortcake trifles. These cute desserts have layers of fresh cake, fresh strawberries, and a special two-ingredient whipped cream that is so yummy you're gonna wanna put it on everything. These are also great make-ahead desserts as you can make them up to 24 hours in advance before serving. I'm Adriana, and if you enjoy learning from in-depth baking tutorials, go ahead and join me by subscribing. Now let me show you every step on how to make these mini trifles. Trifles are desserts that have layers, and you want to be able to see the layers, so you're going to need a large trifle bowl like this one, or you can use the mini glasses like I am. Just want to make sure whatever you use is see-through so that you can see the definitive layers of cake, fruit, and cream. So the first thing that we're going to do is prepare the fruit for the trifles. And you can use a jam or prepared jellies for this step, but I always really love fresh fruit in my trifles. And what we're going to do is prepare a fresh strawberry sauce by macerating some strawberries in sugar. Macerating in this case is just a fancy word for marinating the strawberries in sugar. So what we're going to do is cut up 1 pound of strawberries into a bowl and then add a few tablespoons of sugar and let that sit. Strawberries contain a high amount of water. If you've ever crushed them to make a jam or something like that, you'll realize that a lot of liquid or water comes out. So what's happening is that because we're marinating in the sugar and the sugar concentration is higher outside the strawberry than inside the strawberry, the water flows from inside the strawberry to out. And the result of this process are these really super soft, sweet strawberries that are bathed in this strawberry flavored syrup. So here's a teeny bit of science for you today. This is called osmosis. So osmosis is water traveling through a semi-permeable membrane, which in this case is a strawberry, from a low concentration of sugar to a high concentration of sugar outside the strawberry. The longer you let your strawberries macerate, the more liquid comes out and creates that sugary syrup. And so I typically do this as a first step to let my strawberries kind of sit and develop. And by the time I'm ready to assemble my trifles in about a half an hour, I find that I have just enough liquid to soak the cake inside the trifles. I then like to slice some whole strawberries in half with their tops attached to save as decoration for the final trifles. Now onto the fillings. So it's definitely easiest to fill little trifle cups with a piping bag, but if you don't have piping bags, you can use a Ziploc bag and pour your filling in there and then just cut the end off of it. I'm using some leftover pastry cream here just to give a little bit of variation in my trifles, but you can use whatever you have on hand, or if you just want to use all whipped cream, you're going to need to double the whipped cream recipe, which I'll have on my website. I'm going to show you how I make the best tasting whipped cream for these trifles, and it uses only 2 ingredients. So to the bowl of your stand mixer that's been fitted with the whisk attachment, you're going to add some heavy cream and some condensed milk. And then you're going to whip that on high speed until it develops soft peaks. So a couple things here. You can use a hand mixer. If you don't have a stand mixer, you just make sure that it's been fitted with the whisk attachment as well. And you want to make sure that your heavy whipping cream and your condensed milk are cold. When your whipping cream is cold, the fat globules or the fat molecules in there are in a solid state. They need to be solid so that they can surround the air bubbles or create air pockets that make up whipped cream. If your whipped cream or your heavy whipping cream is too warm, these fat molecules are in a more liquid state and they're unable to hold air. So that's the primary reason why people can't get their cream to whip up. It's most likely because it's not cold enough. So if you notice, my bowl looked kind of frosty in the beginning of the step, and that's because I placed the whisk in the bowl in the freezer for about 10 to 15 minutes before I started this step. It's because the air in my kitchen was a little bit warm that day, and if you have a cold bowl, that often helps keep the whipped cream really cold. All right, so let's assemble these trifles. I think in general, there's really no rule for the order that you put your ingredients in, but I'll show you how I do it. So I always like to start with cream and end with cream. And then in the middle, I always like the fruit to sit on the cake because I like the juices to soak into the cake. So the number of times you repeat the middle section is going to be dependent on how tall your trifle glasses are or trifle container is. So what I'm going to do is going to look like this. It's going to go cream, cake, strawberry, cream, cake, strawberry, cream. Okay, so let's start with the first glass. And what I have on the bottom is a layer of the condensed milk whipped cream. And then I'm just placing some broken pieces of leftover yellow cake on top of that cream. This is a great way to use up leftover cake, or you can make cake specifically for this dessert, or another option if you don't want to make cake. Two brands that I really like are Costco's Pound Cake, it's really delicious, and Enerman's Pound Cake, which is found in American grocery stores. Then take a couple spoons of your macerated strawberries and place that on top of the cake along with a little bit of the juices that will soak into the cake below. Now I'm going to pipe a little bit of that pastry cream on top of the strawberries, and you can pipe some of that extra condensed milk whipped cream, or you can just spoon some on top like we did for the bottom. And then place more of your broken cake on top. And even if you have crumbs, you can use that too. I promise it all turns into this delicious bite of yumminess because of the strawberries and the whipped cream. And then add a couple more spoonfuls of your strawberries and strawberry syrup. And for the last step, add a little bit of whipped cream on top and then top with one of your halved strawberries. So your finished trifle should look something like this, with all the layers visible along the side of the glass. So like I said earlier, you can definitely do this dessert in a very large trifle bowl and just serve it out of there. But if you're gonna go this mini dessert route with little glasses, the best and most efficient way to assemble these is to do an assembly line. So just go through each glass and add each layer individually, and then just move on to the next ingredient. So here they are, the finished strawberry shortcake trifles. I really love desserts like this because you can use up lots of leftover ingredients in your fridge. You can use up any fresh berries that you have around, or maybe even some fresh peaches macerated in sugar. The cake absorbs all of the fruit juices and turns into this really custardy layer, and this condensed milk whipped cream is something that you're probably going to want to use for just more than these trifles. Of course, this is the perfect make-ahead dessert because all you have to do is cover it with some cling wrap and keep it in the fridge for up to 24 hours. I actually think it tastes a little bit better when it's left to sit. You can find this whole recipe on my blog, Tasty Pastry Kitchen. Thanks for watching and have a great day.